From the Amazon basin to the Nile's winding course, rivers are the lifeblood of our planet. Today, we're diving into the murky waters of the world's most polluted rivers, arteries of our planet now choked with waste and poison. Our journey begins in India, home to the Ganges River. Worshipped by millions, this sacred river holds immense spiritual significance. But the Ganges, once a symbol of purity, is now grappling with a toxic reality. Untreated sewage, industrial discharge, and religious offerings combine in a noxious cocktail, polluting the very river so many hold sacred. Waterborne diseases are rampant, affecting millions who depend on the river for drinking, bathing, and irrigation. Yet amidst this ecological crisis, there is hope. Communities are coming together, implementing innovative solutions to clean up the Ganges. We journey now to Indonesia, to the island of Java, where the Citarum River, once a source of life and livelihood, now flows as a stark reminder of our throwaway culture. The Citarum's waters, once teeming with fish and supporting a vibrant ecosystem, are now choked with a sea of plastic. Thousands of factories line the riverbanks, there untreated effluent and a toxic concoction of chemicals and heavy metals discharged directly into the Citarum. The impact on human life is catastrophic. Villages along the riverbank grapple with contaminated water supplies, leading to skin diseases, respiratory illnesses, and long-term health complications. Yet even in the face of such overwhelming pollution, glimmers of hope emerge. Local communities are organizing river cleanups, determined to reclaim their Citarum. Government initiatives are underway to tackle industrial pollution and promote sustainable waste management practices. Our journey takes us now to China, to the cradle of Chinese civilization, where the Yellow River or Huanghe carves its way across the North China Plain. This mighty river, a source of life and legend, is now battling the consequences of China's rapid development. The very waters that nourished ancient dynasties are now tainted with a cocktail of industrial waste, agricultural runoff, and untreated sewage. The impact on the Yellow River's ecosystem is alarming. Fish species are disappearing at an alarming rate, their populations decimated by pollution. Yet China is not oblivious to the Yellow River's plight. Ambitious projects are underway to control pollution, restore ecosystems, and ensure the long-term health of this vital waterway. The task is immense, but the Chinese people, with their deep reverence for nature and history, are determined to restore the Yellow River to its former glory. We return now to India, to the Yamuna River, a major tributary of the Ganges and a poignant symbol of human impact on the natural world. Once a thriving ecosystem, the Yamuna is now a shadow of its former self, its waters choked with pollution and its wildlife decimated. Untreated sewage, industrial effluent and plastic waste pour into the river relentlessly, suffocating its lifeblood. The impact on human communities is equally profound. Those living along the river's edge, often the poorest and most marginalized, are forced to rely on contaminated water for their daily needs. Yet, even amidst this despair, glimmers of hope emerge. Local communities are taking action, organizing river cleanups and advocating for change. Our journey now takes us to Bangladesh, a land crisscrossed by rivers and deeply connected to their life-giving waters. Here, we find the Buriganga River flowing through the heart of Dhaka, Bangladesh's bustling capital city. The Buriganga's waters, once teeming with fish and supporting a vibrant ecosystem, are now suffocating under a thick blanket of pollution. Untreated sewage from Dhaka's burgeoning population flows directly into the river, turning its waters into a toxic soup. Industrial waste from the numerous factories and tanneries lining the riverbanks adds to the Buriganga's toxic load, yet even in the face of such overwhelming challenges, hope flickers. Local communities are organizing to clean up the Buriganga, their determination fueled by a deep-seated love for their river. The government is slowly implementing measures to control industrial pollution and improve waste management. Our journey takes us to the Philippines, to the island of Luzon, where the Marileo River, once a vital artery of life, now stands as a stark reminder of the devastating impact of pollution. For decades, the Marileo River has borne the brunt of unchecked industrial and agricultural runoff. Factories discharge their waste with impunity, turning the river into a toxic cocktail of heavy metals and chemicals. The once thriving fish populations dwindled, their numbers decimated by the polluted waters, but the people of Marilao refused to give up on their river. Local communities, driven by a deep-seated love for their environment, organized themselves into clean-up brigades. Government agencies took notice, implementing stricter regulations on industrial discharge and promoting sustainable agricultural practices. Our journey now takes us to the heartland of America, to the mighty Mississippi River, a waterway that has shaped the nation's history, culture, and economy. But this iconic river is facing a growing crisis: pollution. Agricultural runoff is a major culprit. Fertilizers and pesticides used extensively in the vast farmlands of the Mississippi River Basin flow into the river, carrying with them a toxic load of nitrogen and phosphorus. These nutrients fuel massive algal blooms in the Gulf of Mexico, creating vast dead zones where marine life cannot survive. Industrial discharge adds to the river's toxic burden. Factories and power plants release a witch's brew of chemicals, heavy metals, and other pollutants into the Mississippi, contaminating its waters and accumulating in the food chain. Our journey culminates in Africa, at the cradle of civilization, where the Nile River, the longest river in the world, flows through arid landscapes, sustaining life and shaping history for millennia. But even this mighty river, a symbol of resilience and endurance, is facing unprecedented challenges. Rapid population growth and urbanization are putting immense pressure on the Nile's fragile ecosystem. Untreated sewage from burgeoning cities and towns flows directly into the river, contaminating its waters and spreading waterborne diseases. Industrial discharge adds to the toxic burden. Yet, amidst these challenges, there is a glimmer of hope. Governments and communities along the Nile Basin are beginning to recognize the urgent need for action. As we've journeyed across the globe, witnessing the plight of these polluted rivers, one message rings clear: our actions have consequences. The pollution of our waterways is a global crisis, a threat not only to the health of our planet, but to the well-being of humanity. But it's not too late to turn the tide. We all have a role to play in protecting our water sources.